Come So shall we start? You are there? Now time is 11:05.
Yes, we can start.
So at the outset, good morning to all of you, and you are most welcome on behalf of the Vishwa Bharati Library Network as well as the Central Library. So as you know, in general, we are used to organize such kind of special session throughout the year, basically twice a month. So last couple of few days before, we have already organized and ended successfully our 3-day special session. And today, from the first day of our another 3-day special session. So, as you know, today's topic is similarity checking by using Urkund, or as the Urkund is renamed as the original. And tomorrow there is another session on registration in Vidyan database. And after tomorrow there is another session on remote access through the LS Discovery, our new platform. So before going to our deliberation, may I request all the participants please mute by phone and rename your name originally instead of the mobile number, etc. So as you know, today's speaker is none other than our respected university librarian, Dr. Nimai Chand Saha, because he is the master of the such kind of research ethics and as well also the nodal officer of the Urkund on behalf of our Vishwa Bharati University. As you know, this is the very burning issue of today regarding the plagiarism checking, research ethic, etc. In our university, we have a research committee too, and our university librarian, Dr. Nimai Chand Saha, is also the important member of the research ethics committee. So we are going to start our today's session. May I request Nimaida, please go ahead. Nimaida, please. So Nimaida?
Okay. Let me share the screen.
Okay, I have already. And no need to introduce separately or Nimaida, because every body, those who are associated Vishwa Bharati, all are familiar with the Nimaida, and he is now the leader of the Vishwa Bharati Library Network. Under his able leadership, we are going in for pandemic situation also. So Nimaida.
Okay. So I think my screen is visible to you all.
Yes.
And my audio is also reachable to you all.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So, a very good morning to the academic galaxy of in and out of Vishwa Bharati. From the name list, as I found that there are some candidates, since our notification have been uploaded in the university website, I am very pleased to say that some candidates, those who are not associated with Vishwa Bharati still, the topic is associated with the academics journey. So that's why they have joined. They are most welcome too. You see, usually Vishwa Bharati Library, as a part of our enhancement of research and academics quality, publication quality, research ethics, publication ethics, and to be the part of the academic activities, it's our regular features to organize this kind of special session, methodology workshop, and other things every now and then, not only simply because of, since next month NAC is supposed to come, that's why Viswajit Library is going to do these things, not that. And last month also, rightly my colleague Dr. Kaushik was told that last month we have also organized 3-day special session. 3 topics have been covered there. And this time also we are coming before you on the basis of your request and feedback that academics need to have a session on research ethics, publication ethics, or plagiarism checking, similarity checking, like that. And of course, there is another issue called Vidyan and registration. Someone is on the road and happens to be biking. Please mute yourself. It's disturbing on the floor. Someone is biking on the road and he is just unmute his audio, and that's why we are receiving some noise in the floor. So please. Then, see, actually, third day we will come over here again with LS Discovery for remote access and discovery services. And tomorrow, Vidyan and Aidens registration, which will be coordinated or delivered or demonstrated by my colleague Dr. Kaushik Ghosh. And the last day, LS Discovery, remote access discovery, will be delivered by my colleague Dr. Sabhat Mausin. And today, myself is getting the chance to share my views, like many occasions, and everywhere I'm saying the presentation and sharing my experience on these things. And let me just go around by slide to slide. You see, the very caption of the presentation is similarity checking through our original oblique Urkund. Our original is nothing but the renaming of the old name of Urkund. Or you can say, our original is the new name of Urkund. Software is same, producer is same, features is same. The company itself, it's a basically CDS product. So they have renamed their software by our original. That is, U is the extra there. Original, if it is English pronunciation, it is called original. But as CDS, they are just adding U there, and their pronunciation is our original. But it is original to us, means whatever we have going to publish, whatever we are going to submit, be it assignment, be it dissertation, be it master's dissertation or MPhil dissertation, be it PhD thesis or postdoctoral thesis, or any kind of research publication or book publication or conference proceedings, whatever it is, or book chapter, every time people need to go. Oh,
yes, sir, Tanmay, please.
Tanmay.
Okay, Nimaida.
Okay. So, Adya, so you see, this originality checking means whatever I am going to submit or publish by my name, how much of the content and text is my own creation. That's the basic things of this similarity checking. And you can say in another mode, this is called a part of maintenance of ethics in publication and research arena. So similarity checking, why I am naming the presentation topic as similarity checking instead of plagiarism checking. See, there are many misconceptions hangover in the academic corridor that this Urkund or original or Turnitin or Authenticate or Plagicheck, Plagcheck, or there are softwares are there in the market. So softwares, any software, they are not supposed to check the level of plagiarism. Rather, they are checking the level of similarity, mere similarity. But after getting the similarity level, it's our duty to define whether this similarity will be noted or recommended as plagiarism or not. Because all similarity may not be the part of the plagiarism. And I'm in my presentation, I'm just going to show it online demonstration also. Due to technical glitches, if we are getting some threads, so that's why I'm also taking some snapshot. So let us see how internet backup is going on and how we are lucky to go and experience around the online demonstration like that. So let me go the slide by slide. My next slide is just going to show the presentation backup. There are 7 different agenda. Of course, as a part of every presentation, introduction and conclusion is the customary slide. And another 5 is the research basics, research publication ethics, AGC mandate, issues on plagiarism, then our main content is called Urkund or original snapshot, or it can be shown by demonstration. See, here I'm not going to discuss anything on research methodology or research by its definition, by its literature. Rather, here I am just going to replicate what is the experience, what I am experienced from Vishwabharati in particular and in research in general, that why academics and research scholars are suffering and misleading or misguiding this research concept and other things, and how intelligently, how efficiently we can curb or avoid from this dangerous disease of the academic society called plagiarism.
Nijute ki cholche sir presentation ki sir nijute kichu presentation.
So let me come next slide, that is introduction. See, in the first slide I am just going to show you some none other than electrical bulbs, or you can say LED and some other things. Why I am going to show this slide at the very outset? Because you see, through our research eye, we want to review, we want to reconfigure, we want to represent the old things in the new aspects, in the new requirements, in answering of new questions like that, particularly in case of social science. But in case of applied science and soft science too, and there we are having some product of or output of research is a tangible item, is a touchable, visible, called tangible item. Like in medicine, this corona vaccine, or you know, some medicine, some treatment, everything is tablet, you know, some syrup, liquid, we are eating and we are touching, TV, mobile, then this laptop, this mouse, spectacles, many things. This is because of scientific invention. But in case of social science and language literature, rather say humanities, we are having just our old things. We are going to see in our new questions answering pattern, in our new requirement, in our current socio-pedagogical requirements. Like, if it was not possible, then there is, oh, I am receiving so much of odd noise.
Continue to
Kaushikda.
I am continue to unmute.
Hello, Kaushikda.
Hey,
Masadul Islam.
Ami kore jacchi. Ami constant kore
jacchi. Okay. Now you see, then this, if it was not true, then perhaps there was no more need to do research on Gurudev Tagore, Shakespeare, some other pioneering personalities. Why this is so? Simply because the eye and objective and the curiosity of a particular scholar is completely different, which has not been done by other colleagues and scholars. So that is why this bulb is, we are just going to encapsulate the new light in the research arena on any great personality, on any topic or any species of a particular subject in case of humanities and social science. But in case of science, bit different, but the logic is same. We are just going to reconfigure, rejuvenate our society with our new scientific invention, so that this human civilization is surviving from this coronavirus, from any carcinoma disease, and from many other things like this ICT gadgets and other things. Now, like everywhere, if we want to reach our goal, if we want to touch our objective, we need to go step to step like a stair. And here I am just going to show, at the very outset, scholars need to set the goal, then make a plan, then in the third step, get to work, to start the work, then stick to it, I mean confinement. After starting the work, scholars just running over or hangover in the sea of knowledge. Then he or she, just like a child in a room to play around, what is to be taken and what is not to be taken. And earlier, if I had included in my objective that line, then I think it could have been good one. So he or she is just fumbling what is to be excluded and what is to be included. And they are none other than supervisor and guides. They are playing pivotal role for the truncation, confinement on a particular arena. Otherwise, scholars will be diverted as the sea of universe of knowledge is unending and there is no limitation on confinement of its area. Then finally, he or she may be able to reach the goal. Now, let me quickly switch over to research basics. See, to me, if I am not going to any fundamental definition or ethical aspects or literary aspects of research, just simply take it. The research starts with a piece of information and end with another or new piece or pieces of information. Let's say I'm starting with a question and I'm leaving my research with answer of this question and left some other questions. What is called actually research gap? And that is why research and education is a kind of journey, not the station. So starts with a piece of information or question and ends with a piece of information or answer and leave with some more questions for the further research. Or you can say starts with an understanding and ends with another understanding through question, observation, interview, experiment, discussion, analysis, interpretation. All these facets are the basic modalities to proceed with a research work. A detailed and careful study of something to find out more information about it. A detailed and careful, you can say concrete study of something to find out more information or deeper information about it. And finally, the research output may be tangible and intangible both. In case of some subject, research output will be intangible, maybe intangible, and in case of some subject, research output may be tangible, as I told in introduction. Now, to start with the research, there are 9 different facets we have to handle or any scholars need to handle. Number one, thinking and idea. I'm not going to elaborately discuss on this thing. Just let me just utter the facet because this is not the today's main point of discussion. This is just, to come to the main point, we need to have some background discussion. That's why as a part of discussion in coursework class, I will discuss these things in elaborate manner. So thinking and idea, transform idea into question, then review literature, then design and study, design study and methods, then framing research proposal, then 6, obtain ethical approval. I mean, after formulating the research proposal, I cannot say synopsis. Mind it, very consciously, I am using the term research proposal, not the synopsis, because synopsis will only be possible to prepare or construct or design after the 200 pages or 100 pages or 300 pages, thesis is to be completed or written up. Afterwards, the summary of the thesis will be called as synopsis, and the summary of the synopsis, or more emphatically, we can say synopsis of synopsis called abstract. But at the very earlier stage, those who are just admitted themselves in coursework classes, after qualifying the examination, they need to come before the Board of Research Studies in BRS meeting with 15 pages, 20 pages, or 10 pages proposal. That is called research proposal. And if internal expert or external expert throw any guideline, any, addition, modification, deletion, that need to be adhered by that time. And that is why it is called proposal. Proposal is open end. Every time it may be addressed, it may be modified, it may be edited. But soon after having registration, the very particular topic or the title of the thesis of the work is a registered or patent item of the registered scholars. And that is why the basic paraphernalia of registration. Some scholars don't know why this registration process is required. So this is the basic reasons why we need to have approval or registration on a particular topic of a particular area of a particular subject, simply because these things. Then after the registration, this research proposal need to be uploaded in the Shodh Gangotri database to inform rest of the country, not only India, that academics, friends and colleagues, this particular topic is registered under my name. So don't touch this same title by any other. If you do, then you will be held responsible, since my registration date is earlier than you like that. But if you are not uploading in the proposal, this research, approved research proposal in the Shodh Gangotri, then if anyone registered after you and they have submitted before you, then he or she will be clean cheated, and he or she will be a pioneer. He will be plagiarizer like that. So it's our fundamental duty. After having research proposal approval, we must upload it in the Shodh Gangotri database, either through library or anyone can do by their own. And soon after they uploaded it, I being university coordinator, it will come to my box. And once I approve it, then Delhi will approve it for uploading. So there are two ways. Candidate can do by their own, or they can send it to the library and library people can do it. Then collect and collate data, analyze and interpret data, then disseminating the findings. So these are the core 9 arena of handling a research topic. This is another presentation of 9 arena. I'm not going to read out or detailing. This is a flowchart of research program from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And
sir, can I ask a question, sir?
Regarding this? No. I will take the question answer.
You will submit your query through chat box also. You are most welcome.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Then this is the mirror of research flowchart. And you see 1 to 5, this is the core body and heart. And every facet, there I have some questions. And again, left and right hand, the probable area or answer of that question, which will very, very useful to any scholar, that Nimaida, what should I write under the introduction? What should I write in the literature review? What should I write in methodology? What is the preliminary data? What is the confinement or limitation or the statement of the problem? Or, you know, the scope like that. And then conclusion like that. Then this is a slide through which we are just going to show that the qualitative and quantitative research, its different facets, side by side handling, how to handle a quantitative research and how to handle a qualitative research. So, and don't worry, those who are participate, particularly scholars and others, don't worry to take the mobile picture of this presentation. Soon after this lecture is over, if you require, the PDF of this presentation will be uploaded in my library website under tutorial. You can access it throughout the days, throughout the times. So don't worry about that. Then let me come to research and publication ethics. See, if I'm not going to confine or denoted me much masters on ethics, like philosophical ethics or philanthropical ethics or literary ethics, forget about that thing. But one thing we all know, that whenever we come out from the house and we want to walk, we want to cycling, we want to biking in the road, we follow the left hand side. Why this is? Simply because to avoid accident. Simply because to avoid any accident. And not only my accident, my life, and also to save other lives. Likewise, here in the research arena or academics arena, we will maintain and we will induce ourselves research ethics or publication ethics simply because to save my career, to save others' career, and to ensure the safe journey in the academic arena. Otherwise, my today's publication, my today's dissertation, my today's thesis may arrest me even after 20 years or even after a decade. And perhaps many of you might be knowing that because of these plagiarism issues, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Pondicherry Central University has been removed from his chair in the year 2017. simply because of plagiarism issues. So my academics galaxy, including scholars, please be adhered that. And that is why the scholars, those who are coming to me, I am asking them, it is better not to do research. If you want to do it efficiently, do it ethically, do it honestly, do it consciously, like that. And you see, the five principles for research ethics is that this discuss intellectual property frankly and honestly. Be conscious of multiple roles. Means somewhere you are copying and going to play that it is mine. And somewhere you can take data and manipulate the data. And many a times we found that, particularly in survey-based work, if a student, if a scholar or student survey 50 or 60 candidates, then the trend he can multiply it by 10 or 100. Then he show that I am making survey on 500 people, 600 people. So that is the multiple role and which is fabrication of data. Don't do that things. And the experts will immediately come to know whether it is factual data or manipulated data or versatile data, like that. Follow informed and consent rules. Respect confidentiality and partiality, for privacy. Let's see that sometimes through questionnaire, I can collect some data which is highly personal, but the respondent will give only because or simply because that I need to convene a research or academic programs, and for any other things, I will not disclose the data by any name for specific data. And many a times it is found that the scholars in the thesis, they may not, but in future, when they come up with a book, when they come up with a book chapter, when they come up with a journal article, that time by name, they are noting something which is a very, wrong work against a respondent. And that is why nowadays, respondents are very, very clever. They are not very keen. They are not very eager to give you the factual data. Then finally, tap into ethics resources. Ethics resources means there are many license agreements with us to different publishers, different authors, and every publishers, they have their policy of ethical aspects, whether this can be shared by any other or this cannot be. And for this, in another session or in a coursework class, I will elaborate these things, that there is a website called Sherpa Romeo. Anyone can type in the Google Sherpa Romeo, then there is one website will come, and under that website you will get in and out Indian fabulous and renowned publishers. They have their own publication policy. What is called gold path, what is called yellow path, what is called green path, what is called white path. So there are full four paths through which whenever I am just going to hand over a title or any article to that particular publishers, copyright and patent right and digital rights management, how it will be handled by the publisher, and I am ready to adhere. Then, soon after my presentation is over, I am ready to receive a question that, Nimaida, then why are you asking us to submit our research publication for uploading in the Viswabharati library website or institutional repositories? See, here we have to clear justification and clarification. Everywhere, whenever we send a paper, we note out my affiliation, that librarian Viswabharati, associate professor, department of English, professor, department of physics, professor, department of chemistry, like that. So since we all the members of the Viswabharati fraternity, I have every right, I have every point to read the article published by my academics fellow of Viswabharati free of cost for the acceleration of the academic work by maintaining fair use doctrine. You just follow here, every word have some sort of encapsulation important, highly important, that fair use doctrine, academic activity, maintaining the fair use doctrine and some other ethics means proper citation and referencing and other things. And of course, you must follow whenever we uploaded your paper in the Biswarati library, institution repositories, by sitting in your house, whomsoever you, you cannot be able to download the article from outside Biswabharati because that is password protected. And if you are the Biswabharati fraternity member having library card number, we will share you the password, then only you will be able to open it. So we are not going to violate the copyright and digital rights management issues there. Very consciously, we are nurturing the ethical aspects of publication issues. Now, the academic integrity, what is actually the term enunciated and induced by UGC through its different regulations, basically 2018-31 regulations, this academic integrity nowadays is very, very important, indispensable. Someone can say vicious issues, someone can say simple issues. Whatever the adjective we can use before the issues, it is issues. We need to adhere for 5 fundamental values: honesty, trust, fairness, mutual respect, and responsibility. So these are the 5 things. Now I am not going to read out this text part of why is academic integrity important. There are many reasons, but 4 reasons are very, very important. Having academic integrity means that others can trust you. It's very, very important that I have 100 publications, but my academic community is not trust you because I have taken here and there and trying to copy and paste like that. So I have many publications, but I cannot have trust in the subject specialist or my specific area forum like that. Then second, having academic integrity is important because it provides value to your degree. It's value to your academic confidence. Then employers prefer to hire graduates whom they believe to have high personal integrity. And that is why the last advertisement by Biswabharati, there it was clearly mandated and checking report like that. Then thirdly, having academic integrity is important because it can offer you peace of mind knowing that you believe in doing the right thing. Peace of mind knowing that you believe in doing the right thing, which is very, very rare thing during this pandemic society. What will be our third flow of corona?
Hello, Nimaida.
No sound, Nimaida.
Hello, Nimaida. Jishnu.
Koshida, kichu shona jacche na.
I'm chesta korchi bolar. Hello. Hello, Jishnu. So there is a technical problem, so bear with us. It will take another 1 or 2 minutes. Thank you.
Hello, Kaushik, am I audible?
এবার শোনা যাচ্ছে. ওকে ওকে.
Sorry for the technical glitches. Let me.
I have already informed.
Yes, I was here.
Okay, you may proceed, Nimaida.
And you see, finally, acting with integrity can reduce a lot of unnecessary stress in your life, making you happier, healthier, and more productive. So these are the core facets for which we need to maintain the academic integrity. We need to adhere to the publication ethics, research ethics, similarity checking, and these are the things. These are the nowadays added features of the research methodology like that. In tradition, we are just studying fundamental research, research styles, research design, hypothesis, literature review, write-up, research proposal like that. But nowadays, as far as the current technology society is concerned, we need to adhere to this added features too. Now, just try to go how may I going through the UGC mandates and other things for
অনেকগুলো ফুলে গেছে.
So let me just switch over to maintain this research or publication ethics or integrity or whatever it is. How do I guide myself? So don't worry about that. UGC is there to guide ourselves. And thereafter, our concerned university, then concerned BRS, then research policy, and finally scholar himself or herself. So you see, this UGC had published one notification in the year 2018, 31st of July, that called research regulations here. Yes, research regulations. Then you see the meeting, originally this meeting has been done in the 23rd of July, and gazette notification was published 31st of July 2018. Here the 16 pages clearly given the manner of the plagiarism in higher educational institutes called plagiarism regulation 2018. Here everything clearly mandated. Just to go around, it is 16 pages. It's not for 16 pages. It is bilingual, Hindi and English, 6 to 7 pages. Just 30 minutes you can pay, and you will be able to know how this research revision would like to seen by our UGC. Then you see, in the year 2019 December, there is another order published by UGC called Research and Publication Ethics. That ethics attached a annexure, where they have given a course material and particular the module or topic, hour of lecture duration, and the weight, how much carry it will be, clearly mandated there. Every research board need to include these things in the coursework syllabi, and this should be proceed accordingly. Otherwise, the research coursework syllabus cannot be a complete one. and this is published in the year 2019 December only. Now you see the self plagiarism. This is another very, very important and crucial issues. 20th April 2020 has been published. That many scholars asked me that, Nimaida, I have published one paper in a journal or in a book as a book chapter, the same article, why can I not used in detail in a thesis as a chapter? That cannot be, because once you published a paper in the academic arena, that cannot be reused by you in 1 to 10 pages in total, in a thesis as a chapter or in a book as a chapter, because this will be counted twice. Earlier you have published this paper as a paper, and now you are going to count these things as a chapter or thesis. That cannot be. But as a part of the research publication, you have every right to use this part of your publication in the entire 200 pages of the thesis in 20-30 different positions, somewhere in a line, somewhere in a para, somewhere like that. And you have to give proper citation and referencing to avoid self-plagiarism. So here this one page notice clearly mandated that Kaushik, am I not audible?
Go ahead, Nimaida. Audible.
Yeah. Someone is posting in the chat box that he or she is not able to reach my audio. That may be a hard problem, I think.
Hopefully, because
it is audible. Very clear, Nimaida. Please go on.
Okay. Thank you. Not moving. Our laptop has changed. I am looking at it. Yes. Now this is the another one activity to guide us for CARE research. AGC grant permission given, AGC CARE. The CARE means consortia or consortium for academic and research ethics. This consortium for academic and research ethics, usually we say in the academic corridor, is that CARE listed journal like that. So that CARE means consortium for academic and research ethics. So you have to search the journal name in this CARE list before to publish an article in any journal. If it is not EGC CARE listed, then your publication will not be considered as a kind of academic publication, which cannot be treated in your recruitment or promotional avenues or selection avenues like that. Now, certainly one question may come to your mind that this is come into being in 2019 onwards. What about before that? Many of you know that after 2014 to 2019, it was in UGC enlisted journal. More than 48,000 journals were enlisted there. And before that, if you ask me, what was the scene? The scene was that 2009 to 2014, there was called UGC journals having ISSN number or index number. And before 2019, there was no such guideline by the UGC. So if you have any publication before 2019, don't worry about that. If you have any publication in the year 2012, you will be qualified and evaluated on the basis of the regulation of 2019 to 2014. If you have any publication in the year 2017, you will be evaluated by 2014 to 2019. And if you published any journal by today, you will be evaluated only CARE listed issues and other things. So don't mix it up. Sometimes, and many a times I found these questions, and you mind that time CARE list was not there, how can I do so? Even many a times as I found, if don't take it otherwise, senior academics for having not clear perception on this, they just going to evaluate all publications through CARE list, all publications through UGC enlisted journal like that. But sir and madam, when this concept was not there, how can you just going to evaluate old publication by new regulations like that? Now let me come to issues on plagiarism. So you see, simple thing, don't read this para as well, but without citation referencing, to me it is called full acknowledgement. If you use anyone or earlier any publications part in your write-up without citation and referencing, it will be treated as plagiarism. Simple thing. And many a times, even if my software give you the result is 0%, analysis result or similarity percentage is 0, that cannot be a joyful result. And many a times, if you found that you are having 13% or
7%.
Sir, sorry.
The slides are not moving, sir.
Slide are not visible.
The slide and
visible not no, slides are not moving, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. Slides are not moving. Kindly okay, change
you,
it,
thank
sir.
You, thank you. Let me recheck. Let me recheck. Yes. Hope now slide is changing and it is visible to you.
Yes, Nimaida, yes.
Okay. Yes, sir. Now we can.
Okay.
You may proceed.
Yeah. So without citation and referencing, that is called plagiarism. So please mind it. There is the grammar of research methodology called. And here full acknowledgement does not meet the first page of acknowledgement. Usually we write as a part of preliminary. And that acknowledgement is nothing but a kind of customary page. So is this acknowledgement is, and that acknowledgement is completely different. Here full acknowledgement means academic acknowledgement called citation and referencing. So you need to do it in the thing. Then citing, referencing and bibliographies, it will take another issues. What is the difference between one to other? Let me just skip this thing. But citing means, let me say, the in-text citation, whenever I take a line from any other write-up, soon after the line in finish or para is finishing, I need to give a citation based on any international citation style, like Chicago APA or, you know, Chicago APA MLA, and there are many more too. So based on that, we need to give citing, and at the end of the chapter, we need to give referencing, and at the end of the thesis, all referencing and some others which are not directly used in the thesis will come together called bibliographies. And let me just say, the bibliographies means in the early dawn of the human civilization, biblio is a kind of Latin word called books, and graphies, again, a Latin word called list. So bibliographies is, means list of books. And early civilization, only books were the only source of research arena. So that's why it is called bibliographies. And nowadays, not only the list is confined only books, right from the books, newspaper, then thesis, then journal article, then patent, standards, specifications, monographs, manuscripts, and apart from the tangible or printing media, now we are reaching to invisible media called electronic media too. So all these things coming together under the referencing, under the citation, and bibliographies too. So bibliographies does not entail only list of books. Many have wrong ideas that if a headline is bibliographies, I cannot use that thing. See, take it as bibliography as a kind of umbrella term, not in a rigid term like that. Now, by this slide, I'm just trying to show what is the difference in between referencing and citing. Here you see, this is my write-up in the left panel, and this Rodriguez 2003 is a kind of citation. Soon after the write-up of this Rodriguez 2003 will come here. And at the end of the write-up or at the end of the chapter, This is the reference style based on any international citation or referencing style, APA or MLA like that. So this reference will come at the end of the chapter. This citation will come inside the text, that is called citation. And at the end of all the chapters, at the end of the book, at the end of the thesis, at the end of the dissertation, calling that bibliographies. And bibliographies will does not entail this list of references. There are some many other books or references or sources which I have consulted, read, but not directly text, use the text from that books in the present write-up. Some I can take text, that is called referencing, and some I may not take, that is come under bibliography. So bibliography means used text and non-used text sources are called bibliography, and reference means only those texts I have used or sources I have used in my direct write-up. So this is the basic differences in between citation, referencing, and bibliographies. This is the another definition I am giving. Here you can see the usually come at the end of a text and should contain only those work cited within the text. So usually references to cover work cited and additional bibliography to refer to works reader's general background. In contrary, bibliography is any list of references at the end of a text, whether cited or not. Mind it, whether cited or not. But in case of references, it must be cited. So bibliography is an addition of cited and non-cited sources, and reference is only a list of cited sources. This is. Now, even today, there are many things we are getting from Facebook, Twitter, blogs, Massup, Instagram, including WhatsApp and Telegram apps too. Then my question, how can you cite any pieces of information received through WhatsApp or viewing through Facebook, Twitter, Instagram like that? So these are the modern things which you cannot get MLA style or Chicago style print manual like that. For these things, I can refer you to go to Purdue University OWL website. In India or in Bengal, OWL OWL is simply representation of a bird. At a paki naam hoche pancha, amra bird OWL bolte amra pancha at a paki ke buji. But in case of research methodology arena, OWL means online writing laboratory. O for online, W for writing, L for laboratory. So the Purdue University, they have a separate text in the website called OWL. You click there, you get assistance from there, and also you can register there to add value to that site. And 24-hour service is there, how to avoid plagiarism, how to handle English write-up, everything you can get from there. And now this is the Government of India gadget notification of 31st of July 2018. Here you will get how this plagiarism, who are the faculty, who are the staff, who are the researchers like that. Interestingly, you see the first slide here, I am just having 13 slides. I will not go with this slide. If you require, you can download these pages of document from UGC's website, or I can give it to you. And also it is hangover in our library website too. And if you share mail ID, we can share through you your mail ID like that. It's a ready-made and it's available in the UGC site too. So I cannot read all the 16 pages of this thing as a guideline or literary aspect of plagiarism issues in the eye of Government of India through UGC like that. See, what is plagiarism? Means the practice of talking someone else's work or ideas and passing them as one's own. What the faculty? Many people thought that as I am a visiting faculty, or I am a contextual faculty, or I am an ad hoc based faculty, so this regulation will not be imposed on me. Forget about that, days is over. Now, faculty means regular, ad hoc, guest, temporary, visiting. Nowadays, SSCT too, state-aided contractual teachers in the College of Government of West Bengal like that. Then staff, regular, temporary, contractual, outsourced too. Because today you are outsourced worker. And tomorrow when you going for any permanent job, today's publication, you will cited in your career. So that publication will not be adhered to. So that's why our outsourced staff is also under this purview. Then researchers refers to a person conducting academic or scientific research in HIES in different capacities, maybe senior research fellow, maybe junior research fellow, maybe part-time fellow, whomsoever, getting registration, maintaining a particular research regulation by a particular university, they will be termed as researchers. Not that I am doing distance mode, not that I am doing particular part-time mode, let that like. Then what the student university program, let me just keep to manage the time. Then script, in many cases, in language case, and in drama, language, literature, we found that, no, this is my script. Why this can be counted as a plagiarism matter and other things? Not that. Even in the Durga Puja, even in the Desh Patrika, on the occasion of Durga Puja, we have found many articles published in Desh Patrika or Puja, Puja edition like that. So that script may not be counted as script. If you copied to write up on that particular script from anywhere else, that is why you will be counted as a plagiarism issues. Then source, what will be counted as source? That is clearly noted here. Then what is the basic objectives of this plagiarism regulations? Simply, Government of India is going to showcase its research quality before the rest of the country, rest of the world in global scenario. To responsible conduct of research, thesis, dissertation, promotion of academic integrity, and prevention of misconduct, including plagiarism. Establish institutional mechanism through education and training to facilitate responsible conduct. Here, for Viswabharati community, I can say that our research mechanism has been finalized, formulated by a committee constituted by the appropriate authority, which is awaited for approval of the Academic Council. Once the same has been approved by the Academic Council, then our long pending dream will come to reality finally, that from 2014, some people like me who are caught to come out with the policy. What is the policy of Viswabharati regarding its plagiarism? So that has been formulated. I think that will come very soon after the Academic Council and EC is over. Then develop system to detect plagiarism and to set up mechanism to prevent plagiarism and punish a student, faculty, researchers, or a staff. You see, everyone is under the purview of the punishment, be it student, be it scholar, be it faculty, be it staff. Now, how to curb plagiarism? There are several ways that how to curb plagiarism, and everything, don't worry, and don't consider this thing as a lion concept, tiger concept, not that. Very, very simple thing, that the open truth, open formula, basic lab techniques, common or generic term of a particular subject will not be considered as plagiarism. It is clearly mandated and noted in these regulations. Okay, and these are the several points which you can go through by your own. And the entire plagiarism scenario,
okay,
this three core area is excluded from the text. All quoted work reproduced with permission and or attribution. Number two, all references, bibliography, table of content, preface, and acknowledgement. And finally, all generic terms, laws, standard symbols, standard equations, another thing will not come under the purview of plagiarism issues. Now, that the entire plagiarism industry or society can be divided into four different compartments. Number one, zero level, that is similarity up to 10%, minor similarities, no penalty. Level one, 10 to 40, similarities above 10 to 40, there is some penalty clause. 40 to 60, there is some penalty clause. 60% and above, there is some penalty clause. What are that? You see, to protect this plagiarism issues, every department have its departmental academic integrity panel in line with the UGC's regulation. Who will be the chairman of the DAIP, head of the department? who will be the member senior academician from outside the department to be nominated by the head of the HEI. Here HEI means Higher Education Institute of India, and in the Shantiniketan it is Vishwa Bharati. Then member, a person well versed with anti-plagiarism rules to be nominated by the head of the department. The tenure of the member in respect of points B and C shall be 2 years. The quorum of the meeting shall be 2 out of 3 members. So you see, everything is clearly mandated here. And what is the time period of submission of report of this DIP? That is also 45 days. So we don't have anything to do by our own. We just ready to our mindset to follow this guideline, nothing else. Then above DAIP, there must have IAIP called Institutional Academic Integrity Panel. So what is the Academic Integrity Panel constitution part? It is chairman, pro VC, dean, senior academician of the HEI, member, senior academician other than chairman, member, one member nominated by the head of the HEI from outside the HEI, means external member. One member who is supposed to be well versed and warranted on this technology. Now penalty clause. You see, number one, level 0, no penalty. Level 1, 10 to 40, such student, here student means scholar, shall be asked to submit a revised script within a stipulated time period not exceeding 6 months. If it is 40 to 60% similarity, such student shall be debarred from submitting a revised script for a period of 1 year. If it is more than 60%, such student's registration for that program shall be treated as cancelled. And I don't know, due to this pandemic, it may be deferred. Otherwise, the September 2021, the new regulation would have been come into being. In this regulation, to me, the news is that the UGC is now going to prepare a fake scholars list. UGC is now going to prepare a list of fake scholars. So every institute or university will be noticed that before giving registration to a particular student, you need to check this list. If that particular name is available in this fake scholars list, he or she will not be allowed to register in Vishwa Bharati or any Indian academic institute for undertaking research. So you see how tough and difficult UGC is going to be to keep us in right track and proper manner. And for teachers or people like me, what will be for us? Similarity 10% minus similarity, no penalty. 10 to 40 shall be asked to withdraw manuscript. 40 to 60 shall be asked to withdraw manuscript, shall be denied a right to 1 annual increment, shall not be allowed to be a supervisor to any new master's MPhil PhD student scholars for a period of 2 years. If it is more than 60%, shall be asked to withdraw manuscript, shall be denied a right to 2 successive annual increments, shall not be allowed to be a supervisor to any new master's MPhil PhD, like. And in the new regulation proposed to be included, that a particular teacher will be forced to go 2 years without pay leave like that. So you see, his or her career will be discontinued. So this tough condition is going to be introduced by UGC. Now this is Purdue Online Writing Laboratory. This is the home page. This general writing, research and citation, teachers and tutor sources, subject specific writing, job search writing, English as a second language write-up, Purdue OWL, Bitcast, then about the OWL, then giving to the OWL, and finally, here is the suggested resources, MLA guide, APA guide, how to navigate the new OWL, different things. So everything you will get here clearly and free of cost, free, and this is open website. Then, this is the inner page of the OWL. So you can go here and induce yourself. This is self-explanatory website. If any problem, any questions, do contact with us. We will try to give you the proper clarification. Then let me switch over to urkun.au original snapshot. See, there are many plagiarism detection software. This green color is open access software. You can check your write-up for first hand. This open access software, you can download and you can upload your paper there to get the the primary report or your understanding that how my writing is going up like that. Then that is duplicate checker, copyscape to Viper. And this red means, not bad, but for this we need to pay money. That is called purchase software or corporate software or not free software like that. So Turnitin is the one of the world famous or popular fabulous software. Then Authenticate, which we are used till 2015. And now we are using Urkund, renaming as, you know, our original, then CopyLeaks to this other things. Now, how can we, being the member of the Vishwa Bharati fraternity, every teachers, faculty members, they have their own account to upload a paper and to download or conceive the analysis report. And if any scholar intend to upload a paper or thesis in the Urkund or original database, they need to request me through a line of mail. I will give them, but they will not be able to conceive the analysis report. So they will be able to upload the paper or thesis in the by using their account, and to get the report, they need to use the analysis address of the particular teacher or supervisor, or they can take the analysis address of the library people, which is appended at the library website under our team. I will show you that thing. How can you get the analysis address of Nimaida or Kaushikda or Jishnuda or some other else? Or better to take it analysis address from your guide, because they will download the report and you are the expert to reconcile whether it is the actual plagiarism or not. If you found that this much of percentage is not the actual plagiarism, then you need to drop that source. If you found that I have properly cited and referred, so you may allow to drop that particular source. Then your similarity checking come from 19% to 7% like that. So this is you people as a subject specialist, it is your duty, but foolishly, scholars are coming to the library, mostly Kaushikda or some others, Dada, and to me to come here to check the report. And after getting 19% or 25%, they are coming here, Nimaida, what do I do like that? Can you please reconfigure the report? I cannot do, because I'm not the master of physics. I'm not the master of English. I am, of course, master of library science or some other basic subject to me. But that is why always this preference will be done by their own. And the report, first page of the report generated by the Urkund will be appended soon after the declaration of the candidate by itself. And whenever you are just going to submit the thesis through DVD in the exam section, that particular page also will be scanned and induced there. So that whenever library will upload your thesis in the South Ganga, rest of the country, rest of the globe will know that this much of percentage is there. Then after 10 years or 20 years, if someone is asking that, Nimaida, your thesis is having this much of percentage, so that time you cannot be worried, because your thesis has been awarded in the year 2021. Afterwards, there are many publications come on the same arena or same species of subject. So you need to give that I have submitted my thesis in the year 2021, but they have published 2026. So how can I have copy in the year 2021 from a copy in the year 2026? First one, it is quite impossible. Number two, sir and madam, please check in the year 2026, that guy may use and copy from my 2021 paper or thesis, so that it is a kind of credit to me on my thesis, as I am getting positive citation follow-up write-up by some fellow colleagues and some fellow academics of the same subject arena. Then simply you just go to Google, then type here original or Urkund anything. Soon after, this is original or Urkund or both, you can type it. Then it will give you original home. Click here by this symbol. I am just going to show what is the particular position to click. So once I click here, original home of our original come towards. Then here it is the login. You just click the login. Then soon after clicking login, this page will come. then being a student to upload a paper, this is not going to problem. Then, or any faculty members or any students to upload a paper, out of these four options, please log into Wave Inbox Global. Click here. Soon after clicking here, you will be giving these four boxes. Ignore these upper two boxes, come to here. Enter your login credentials here, username and password. Username means, how can you get the username? Your mail ID will be your username. When you request me to give one account for upload a document for scholar and for faculty members, every faculty account is there. So their mail ID, either Vishwabharati mail ID or Google mail ID, Gmail ID, is as will be used as ID or username and password, whatever you have set as your password. So that will be you give. And if you click here, remember me, once you log in, next time log in, you need not give this username and password repeatedly. So that you can do. Then soon after giving that login and ID password, this is the landing page of the Urkund minus this area, since it is my used inbox. So this much of papers I have checked, and this is showing the box. First time in your case, it will be vacated. So here you see create and upload. You can click upload to upload a paper. I think I am very, very simpler and easier to participants to reach the step by step where I am just going on. And regarding that PowerPoint presentation, don't worry. Today or tomorrow, the PDF file of this tutorial will be uploaded. Don't worry about that. Then after clicking here, upload, you just upload a files. Okay. When you click this upload a files, you will be giving this page. This is the analysis address. To me, it is librarian.vbuni@analysis.urkund.com. This @analysis.urkund.com is common to every Vishwabharati fraternity. But the first part, it may be different. So that is depending upon the individual ID. Whenever you get one ID, particularly for faculty, this analysis address is for you there. Then subject, maybe English, maybe social work, maybe economics and politics, maybe Odia, whatever it is. Message, you cannot write up something, or you can write something that is optional. You cannot write something. Then upload a file. Soon after clicking this upload a file, then computer or system will ask you to pick up the file from a particular location. See, when I upload a file, then my file may be here. I can pick up any one file. Soon after pick up a file, then this upload will be completed and this portion will be vacated. This is the analysis or similarity percentage. And after 5 minutes, 10 minutes or sometimes, if you refresh, this percentage will come. Soon after the, mind it, soon after the uploading of a paper, it will be vacated. And after the uploading and result will come, you just click the refresh button, then this percentage will come. Then to see where this 19% is becoming, you just click the percentage, any one percentage, the particular report will be opened. So you see, once I click that percentage, this window will come. This is the name of the file, date, and this things. Then open the report. You can click here to view the complete report. And before coming to report, let me utter one thing, that the naming of the file to upload in the original or Urkund, please don't forget to name the scholars. Like me, if my name is Nimai Chan Saha, at least Nimai Saha. Then first 4 or 5 letters of the thesis. Let's say the women empowerment in the light of government scheme, like that. For plagiarism checking or for similarity checking, like that. So name, then few words from the title, starting of the title, so that whenever certificate will come, your name and your thesis name will be appended at the top of the our original or Urkund report. So that's the beauty, the renaming of the file. But in most of the cases, we found that for plagiarism check, for 1, 2, 3, like that. What is the meaning of naming a file of 1, 2, 3 dot PDF? I don't found any sense there, but I don't know why the scholars practicing this kind of things like that. Then you just open the report. soon after opening the report, this screen will come. Now, this you see, from here you can download the PDF report, PDF mode, you can export the report. From here you can see the percentage of similarity. From it is the findings, list of findings, I mean where from it has been matched. Then this is the source. Here you can click to bring down 19% to some come down. So this is the source. You can click. Soon after clicking the source, this page will come. You see, this arccjournals.com, this 12.89 similarity becoming from one particular source. In most of the cases, what I found is that this particular paper has been written by the scholars himself or herself, which is highly related with the thesis. So this is the link of the thing. So then after finding it, you need to cite you need to give the name of the journal, name of the article, publication, volume, etc., etc. In addition to that, it is available, this URL. Accessed on, you can give the date. So you see, machine, the beauty of the machine is that it will bring you unknowing to knowing arena only. Then, now if you confirm, Nimaida, this 12.89, I found that I have, this is our publication or my research-related publication, which have been properly cited and referred, and which is not copy and paste page by page like that. It will be part by part. But throughout 200 pages of the thesis, the total percentage is 12.89 from the single source. But it will be, cannot be exempted. If you give 1 to 10 pages of the paper in the thesis, 1 to 10 pages, copy and paste in total mode. I think, hope I am clear. And if you want to delete this URL or ignore this URL, you just click the drop-down menu, then you will get here, Dropbox. You see this uncheck. Once you uncheck these things, then this 12.89% will be evaporated or deleted or removed. Then your percentage will come 19% minus 12.89 means it will come 6.11 like that. Then finally, if you satisfied, then you can come to download the report. Click here. Then this is the first page of the our original report. You see here, analyze document, it's plagiarism, by Joy Day 2021 PDF like that, and afterwards D some number is there. So this document in the Urkun basket having a permanent document number, it is a permanent deposition in the original database. So one file cannot be checked twice. If second time you are going to check these files in the original, it will show you that it is copied 100% from you to you like that. So this is the thing, and this much of 19% result is coming from this source. Since it is a kind of, you know, screenshot, it will not go bottom of the report. Now, the declaration part, it should be clearly noted. Usually scholars are noting this area that, let me just read this page, that I do hereby declare that the thesis entitled submitted for the award of degree of Doctor of Philosophy in is my original work, and the thesis has not been found the basis for the award of any degree, diploma, associateship, fellowship, or similar other title. To the best of my knowledge, it has not been submitted to any other university or institution for the award of any degree or diploma. Further, this part you have been noted, first para, but the second para you have not noted. And if you are not noted or cited your checking, then your checking will not get any mileage. What is that? Further, the entire text of the thesis has been uploaded in the original or Urkun EGC approved plagiarism checking software for checking the level of significance or similarity on which date. Battery low. Now you see, okay, I'm just. Now you see, further, the entire text of the thesis has been uploaded at which date it has been uploaded, that is 22nd November 2019. The report has been revealed that 6% similarity, which has also been properly reconciled by myself and my guide, and found that all the detected sources are from oblique my, our own publication leading to research, which have been properly cited and referred. Hence, the thesis is ready to submit an award As evident, first page of the report is being enclosed in the next page. Most of the cases in the last year, CAG team also asked me, what is the evidence that your university is following this plagiarism checking? But I am very sorry to say, 7 or 10 theses, I am just going to prove out of 100 theses during last 2-3 years. So this is the picture. This has must be noted. And this second para may be option of or in the next page. I don't know which will be applicable in which cases. So that's why or there are three options. Which one is applicable to anyone, they can follow it. And in our plagiarism policy, this is more elaborated and more mandated. Once that will be uploaded in the investor website, every scholars, every guide need to follow that things. But before that thing, last 7-8 years, I am just going to propagate these things. Who are attended my course or classes and the special session, they are well aware or conversant about this. And you see, Urkund handbook, this is the link. You may not depend on Nimaida, you may not depend on Kaushikda, or you may not depend on any library officers. It's a self-suffice thing. By going and clicking here, you will be getting the Urkund handbook, how to handle these things. Urkund admin guide, you may not require, that is for me only. Then there is a FAQ, frequently answered questions. So there is also FAQ. You can click and see it. And let me just, for today's scholars, those who are already registered and those who are supposed to be registered, my repeated appeal to all of you, please, before to start the formal research work, go through this Urkund website, this handbook and FAQ, and also UGC guideline before to coming to the water of research. Otherwise, there is any chance you may be sunk down there. So this is my warning to all of you, a kind of carry sentence to all of you, one sentence to all of you. Then you see that the research basically starts with a question and ends with a question. And it is a cyclical process. And to me, none of the research is a complete figure. None of the research is going to stop the research society. One research, as I told in conclusion and in findings, we have repeatedly noted. And during Board of Studies, some expert member asked, what is the gap of this research? What is the, do you have any gap study like that? So every time the scholar's mind, cyclical order, round over these 6 questions, what, how, where, why, when, who. So if you able to get the answer of these 6 questions, I think you will be able to rightly track on your proper line. And save practice, save your career, and save our society. Like our Bengal slogan, save drive, save life. To me, and not for this pandemic day, rather to me, this plagiarism issue is a kind of ever-standing pandemic in the academic society. That's why my proverb is safe practice, safe career, and society. And last but not least, let me just retire it with the 2 great quotations given by none other than our one of the greatest academician to me is Professor and former President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam sir. You see, first one is that without your involvement, you can't succeed. With your involvement, you can't fail. So be a research scholar. Without your involvement, your research cannot be succeed. And once you are involved, you cannot fail to succeed your research work like that. And your attitude will be like an eagle. All birds find shelter during a rain, but the eagle avoids rain by flying above the clouds. Problems are common, but attitude makes the differences. Everyone has to handle with some research problems, but the attitude makes a difference how to handle that things. If your attitude is not like this birds, like eagle, then you will be always induce yourself within the problem. So you are trying to come up always with the upper surface of the problem, like in case of eagle, upper surface of the rain to save. You cannot save yourself within the rain, within the problem. So that's my humble submission to you all. And before going to online elaboration or demonstration, let me just open it for discussion. Then during answering, I am just going to switch over to any online demonstration of our journal. Otherwise, I think I am able to reach this PowerPoint presentation or snapshot, how this original will be acted or you will handle. And with these few words, let me just open up for interaction and question, because the participants are a kind of clubbing of, you know, clubbing combination of senior academician to junior scholar. So to scholar, I can expect some questions, and to my academic galaxy, I can expect some suggestion and interaction, so that I can also enrich myself. And if any ambiguity there, then I shall try to find out the proper answer from the UGC guidelines too. So with these few words, let me pass over the forum to my host, Dr. Kaushik Ghosh. If there is any questions in the chat box, he can put up, or if he allow, then our learned participants may interact with me through audio. Kaushik, the please.
So thank you, Nimaida. Actually, it is not the vote of thanks. So because I have already mentioned before that, please furnish your question to the chat box, and few of the questions have already appeared. So I am read out to you so that you can answer before to the online demo. Okay, I'll read.
So me feedback link ta di rio, ha?
I have already submit the feedback. So may I request all the participants please submit the feedback form.
Nimaida, apnar ei lecture ti ki apnader library te upload korben?
Ha, upload to korbo. Er age amar ekta lecture urkunder upor upload kora ache. Etao upload hobe.
Achha.
Etao amader YouTube channel upload hobe.
Thik ache. Tale khub bhalo.
Nimaida, one question.
Ha.
One question from the Gopal Chandra.
Ha.
So sir, my question is that after registering of my topic and uploaded in Shodh Gangotri,
right,
if my topic is further changed by the DRC in some special cases, then what will I do to register my topic in Shodh Gangotri?
See, it is very rare and exceptional cases. The title change is not adorable most of the cases, but if it is, then you need to give a letter to us for removing the earlier version from the Gangotri, then enclosing that report from you and your guide. We need to send it to internet authority. They will remove the thing. We are not supposed to remove the things. And if they allow, then only we will upload that thing. And if it is not there, then in the introduction or declaration in your thesis, you just point out that thing. Initially, registration was on that line. Afterwards, my thesis title have been edited or revised by this board of studies, by this memo number, like that. You need to mention it in the thesis introduction. Introduction means your declaration area. Then that will be squashed. It may be there, but sometimes in some positions, it must be clearly mandated and noted. Otherwise, there is every time we need to have some similarity that the thesis have been started with the Shodh Gangotri title and the thesis concluded with the Shodh Ganga title. In 900% cases, it will be matched up. But 1-2% cases, if title in emergency, it need to be changed, then that need to be added. Otherwise, this is not adorable. This is not welcome. That thesis title will be changed after 3 years or 2 years because the title in past and registered that time, maybe some lacks were there for evaluation and other things. So many questions, undermined questions may come. So better to go ahead with the thesis title. During that time you can do, and it must be uploaded. If you do not upload, to bypass this agenda, you will be under sunk in a water if any problem will come any day, because technology is very, very versatile nowadays.
So this is the same question from Pratyush Rai also. So this is the, so I am not repeat again. So another question. So can I share or publish abstract of my research work? The question from the Monisha Raut. Sir, namaskar. Can I share or publish abstract of my research work in national seminars before publishing in any journal? Will it be called duplication of publication? From Monisha Raut.
Okay. No. You are right, and you do it, because whenever you going to present your thinking of research in any seminar, be it abstract form then if any suggestion will come, if any suggestion will come, then you must note down, you must adhere that suggestion, you must include that suggestion in your thesis, and in the methodology area you can consciously note it that, and if any time you can come to the library or through South Ganga, you can open my thesis, you can go there that I have a quotation from the Vice Chancellor of most likely Tejpur University during a seminar. In an inaugural address, he stated one line which was really acceptable to me in my research arena, and taking permission from sir, I have used that quotation in my research in a box before the introduction chapter. So that is a very fine thing. Whenever you are just going to listen something or discussing someone to get some input on your research, you use it and you just enhance the quality of your research. This will ensure the quality of the research, provided you will note it somewhere in the methodology that what are the steps you have followed to encapsulate, to conceptualize the research problem, to conceptualize the chapterization of the thesis like that. It's a very good thing. That is also part of qualitative research methodology, not the quantitative. So I am in favor of this, and I am following these things, and I support it. Thank you, Monisha, for this kind of nice question.
Sir, excuse me, sir. Sir, I'm Manisha. Sir, actually, I wanted to know if we have submitted the research work in a national seminar, so it gets published in their book, which they release in the seminar. So can I also publish the same work in any journal? Will that be called duplication? That's what I wanted to know.
Once you publish any seminar volume and write today's conference proceedings are not any term. Write today's, everyone is publishing, it is a book form, having ISBN number, because conference proceedings is not having any academic recognition. If you published anything in something where you do not have any ISBN or ISSN number, in case of journal, it is called International Standard Serial Number, ISSN number, and in case of book, it is called ISBN, International Standard Book Number. So earlier conference proceedings, these things is not having any viability. So the things which have been published as a book chapter, that cannot be published in a journal. And that is a very foolish thing, you know. Once you have published your article as a book chapter, that may not be as a conference. Conference matter, you have been discussed, you have been presented, you have been showcased. Then if any suggestion, in the final paper, you have just truncated, you have edited. Then the paper is being published in the chapter as a book. Output of that seminar, true. In the introduction, editor will definitely note that the initially papers have been presented in the seminar, now it has been come through a book. So you are not supposed to publish that book's chapter in any of the journal article. Don't do that.
So next question Poulomi Malik, Research Scholar, Bengaluru Department. Can I upload one of my literary essay paper work of research work for publication at our Vishwabharati Library? Basically, Bengaluru literature.
See, literary essay. Actually, this script, literary essay, all are the local term of the subject, okay? But in the academic corridor, this literary essay means that should have, if it is having citation, referencing, that is a kind of academic write-up. And if the literary essay is being published in any journal having ISSN number, preferably enlisted in the care list, we don't have any problem to upload in the library institutional repositories. That's welcome. But if it is published in any Durga Puja souvenir in the Para Club or Puja, so that write-up or that literary works, maybe quality, but that cannot be taken in the academic corridor, and it cannot be uploaded in any central university library, because that sentiment will not carry any academic significance. One question.
It is not the technical question, because I am answering. From where can we get the recording of the seminar and the resource link? As you know, we have a Vishwabharati Library Network YouTube channel. Please subscribe the channel, and all such kind of lecture series we will already uploaded, and this today and tomorrow and after tomorrow's lecture series will be uploaded soon. So one question from Shambhuddha. So I would like to know the advantages of Urkund over other renowned service such as Turnitin.
See, as I told, there are many software, and every, like any human being, any software, any system is not critic free. Tornitin also have some sort of problem. Authenticate, we have used an experience, have some sort of problem. And Urkund is also not free from problem. But right today, as UGC is giving the software free to us, university, our Viswarthi is not in a position to pay a huge amount to purchase further Tornitin as a repeated software. The IIT and some other institute, those who have money, they are procuring. But preferably, since we are getting these things and government of India paying crores of money to the Swedish agency for Urkund and this original software. So we are compelled to follow these things without having any other software. And Tornitin is having a huge costly software. We are not in a position to purchase that things. Once we purchase that, we can. And you know, in answering of your questions, none of the software, apparently Tornitin has some good features compared to Urkund. That's true. And I am also agreeing with that. As I told, that Tornitin is world fabulous and familiar software. True. Even that, Tornitin has some problems. Then Authenticate have some lacks. Urkund, of course, having some lacking. And our Grammarly Access is having a software for checking something in the plagiarism checking. Whenever you upload any papers in the Grammarly to check the English write-up, preposition, grammar, active voice, passive voice, long sentence to short sentence, like that, this Grammarly is there. We are just subscribing Grammarly for 1 year and it is going on. I request all the scholars, those who have not yet taken the access or accessibility of this Grammarly, do it take. And within the Grammarly, you will get one plagiarism software. So as a primary check, you can do with that. Then finally, before submission, you do check through Urkund and our original. And every software, repeatedly I say, every software and system and human being do not have free from any ambiguity and critics. That is. Sambhuji, kuch question hai ki aap? Sambhu Prasad ji? You are muted. Please unmute. Sambhuji, please unmute yourself.
Okay. Sir, I don't have actually the question. Just I wanted to say that when it comes to information, when it comes to do PhD, when it comes to know about the plagiarism, listening you is very wonderful, sir. I have been driving the car. I have been returning to my home. The whole drive, you make my drive, sir. Wonderful. Then thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay. So nice. Kaushik, any more questions?
Hello, Nimaida. Hello. Nimaida, amar ekta question ache. ইন্টারন্যাশনাল জার্নালে রিলেটেড টু মাই অবজেক্টিভস এরপর ব্যাপার হচ্ছে ধরুন এক একটা চ্যাপ্টার 40 পেজের মতো সেখানে এক একটা থিমের এক একটা চ্যাপ্টার 40 পেজের মতো সেখানে মানে পেপার গুলো ধরুন 15 পেজেস এরপরে 40 পেজেসের মধ্যে পেপারের কিছু অংশ আছে ধরুন 15 পেজেসের মধ্যে ধরুন 8 কি 9 পেজ পেপার মানে পেপারের ওইটা অংশের মধ্যে ইনক্লুডেড আছে সেক্ষেত্রে ধরুন যখন চেক করবেন সেটা তো দেখাবে যে আমি দেখালেন যে 12.5% ছিল
এটা নিয়ে দুবার দীর্ঘ মানে দীর্ঘ একদিন আমার 40 মিনিট কথা হয়েছে
আমি
বুঝে নিয়েছি কারণ আমি তো রাজ্যের নানা তারা করছি আমাকে আর বেশি বোঝাতে হবে না তুমি আমার উত্তর শোনো না নালে তুমি আমাদের পরে আলোচনা করো টেকনিক্যাল পেপার বুঝতে পেরেছো মানে আমরা ছড়িয়ে ফেলেছি এখন নিমাইদাকে আমি ওষুধ চাইছি মানে পেশেন্ট অলরেডি কি বলবো যে ভেন্টিলেশনে আছে এবার তুমি নিমাইদা ডাক্তারকে ডেকেছো আমার হাতে মেডিসিন নেই তোমাকে বাঁচানোর যখন কোনো টেকনিক্যাল রাইটার করতে হয় তখন তোমার থিসিসে চারটে অবজেকটিভ আছে, তুমি চারটে অবজেক্টিভ উপরে চারটে চ্যাপ্টার হয়েছে, ফাইন, সেটা নিয়ে কিছুই বক্তব্য নেই। কিন্তু দেখা গেল তুমি দুটো চ্যাপ্টার তুমি দুটো বই পাবলিশ, সরি দুটো আর্টিকেল পাবলিশ করলে দুটো অবজেক্টিভ নিয়ে, তো তুমি সেই দুটো অবজেক্টিভকে ভেঙে পাঁচটা অবজেক্টিভ করোনি কেন? করলেই তাহলে দেখতে তোমার লেখাটা ছড়িয়ে দেবে, ছড়িয়ে গিয়ে তোমার এই বিভিন্ন চ্যাপ্টারের মধ্যে লেখাটা ভাগ করতো, তাহলে অতটা পার্সেন্টেজ আসে না। তুমি দেখবে তোমার পেপার যখন আপলোড করে দেখবে তখন 35% যদি প্লেজারিজম এসে যায়, সো ইট উইল বি ভেরি ডিফিকাল্ট ইউ টু ডিফেন্ড, এবং তোমার গাইডের পক্ষে ওটা ডিফিকাল্ট হয়ে যাবে। এটা কিন্তু প্লেজারিজম আইনে পড়বে ভাই। তুমি বলছো যে 40 পাতার মধ্যে 8-9 পাতা মিল এসে যাবে, আমি জানি না কত পার্সেন্ট আসবে। তোমাকে ওই রিরাইটিং করা, প্যারাফ্রেজিং করা, সেলফ সাইটেশন করা করেও কত অ্যাভয়েড করতে পারো, ইটস এ বিগ কোয়েশ্চন। তোমার ডিটেলস আমি বুঝিয়েছিলাম সেদিনকে, বুঝতে পেরেছো? সো ডোন্ট ফর দিস থিংস। যখন তুমি এটা করছো থিসিসের অবজেক্টিভ ইন টোটো, আমি কোনো পেপার অবজেক্টিভ রাখবো কেন? আমি ওই অবজেক্টিভ ভেঙে তিনটে করতে পারি, চারটে করতে পারি, ওইটাকে আমি পেপারে রিরাইট করব। আমার থিসিসের অবজেক্টিভ আমি হোয়াই ক্যান আই মেক এ কপি অ্যান্ড পেস্ট ইন আদার পেপারস অবজেক্টিভ, তাই না? তুমি কি করেছো তার উত্তরটা অন্যের কাছে মিনিংলেস হতে পারে, ঠিক আছে? সো আমাদের টাইম অনেকটাই হচ্ছে, অন্য কারোর যদি জেনারিক কোয়েশ্চেন থাকে, তোমার স্পেসিফিক কোয়েশ্চেন, তুমি আমাকে আবার ফোন করবে, মেল করবে, আমি তোমাকে উত্তর দিয়ে দেবো, ঠিক আছে?
ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে। তুমি
স্যার আমার একটা কোশ্চেন আছে, আমি কুনাল আরিসি থেকে বলছি।
হ্যাঁ কুনাল,
হ্যাঁ স্যার একটা কোশ্চেন আছে যে ইউজিসির যে লিস্টে জার্নাল গুলো আছে যেগুলোতে মানে পাবলিশ করা যায় আর কি, তার বাইরে অনেক রিনাউন্ড জার্নাল আছে যেটা ইউজিসির লিস্টে নেই, আমি যদি অনেক আমার পেপার যদি অন্য কোন জার্নালে পাবলিশ করতে চাই, তাহলে সেক্ষেত্রে কি সেটা মানে অ্যাপ্লিকেবল হবে বা হবে না এরকম?
আচ্ছা একটা ভালো ওষুধ আছে, এটা মেডিসিন হচ্ছে এই যে তুমি যদি মনে করো তোমার পেপারের কোনো রিনাউন্ড জার্নাল আছে যেটা ইউজিসি কেয়ার লিস্টে অন্তর্ভুক্ত নয়, তাই না? তুমি তোমার হেড বা গাইডের মাধ্যমে ইউজিসি খুব সিম্পল একটা যদি ফর্ম ফিল আপ করে জার্নালটা ডিটেলসটা দিয়ে দাও, ইট উইল বি ইনকর্পোরেটেড দেয়ার ইন 80% কেসেস, দে আর টু টেক ইট আপ। তাহলে আমি একটা মানে কেয়ার লিস্টের নন লিস্টেড জার্নালে পাবলিশ করার আগে ওইটাকে যদি রিকোয়েস্ট করি 1 মাস কি 2 মাস আগে, দেখবো ওটা কেয়ার লিস্টে এন লিস্টেড হয়ে গেছে। যেমন আমি বলছি শান্তিনিকেতনে, তোমরা জানো যে আমাদের একটা খোয়াই বলে পত্রিকা চলে, যেটা আমাদের এই পাঠভবনের মাস্টারমশাই কিশোরদা দীর্ঘদিন থেকে চালাচ্ছেন। এই পেপারটা আমাদের লাইব্রেরির একজন অফিসার সনদবাবু, যিনি শিক্ষাবন লাইব্রেরির ইনচার্জ, ওনার মনে হয়েছিল, উনি অ্যাপ্লাই করেছেন, ওটা কিন্তু কেয়ার লিস্টে এন লিস্টেড হয়ে গেছে। এইবার তোমরা বলবে যে অনেক আনইম্পর্টেন্ট জার্নাল কেয়ার লিস্টে দেখতে পাচ্ছি, অনেক ইম্পর্টেন্ট জার্নাল বা ভালো জার্নাল দেখতে পাচ্ছি না, তোমাকে কি অ্যাপ্লাই করতে মানা করেছে? ইউ জাস্ট সিম্পলি অ্যাপ্লাই, কোনো পয়সা লাগবে না। আমি বলছি যে তুমি তোমার গাইডকে বলো, তোমার ডিপার্টমেন্টের টিচারদের বলো, একটা মেল করলে এটা তো এসে যাবে। সো ইউজিসি ওই জন্য বসে আছে, সাজেশন চাইছে যে তোমার সাবজেক্টে কোন জার্নালটাকে তুমি ইনক্লুড করতে চাইছো, ইন দিস ওয়ে উই ক্যান এনহ্যান্স দ্য লিস্ট অফ কেয়ার লিস্টে যদি আমরা ভরে দিতে পারি না, তাহলে তোমার তো ফ্রি হয়ে গেলে, তুমি কেন পাবলিশ করবে না? আমি সেইটা বুঝি না, আমরা রোগ বাদ দিয়ে না আমরা উপসর্গের দিকে বেশি ধাবিত হয়ে যাচ্ছি, বুঝতে পেরেছো? এইটা করো,
ওকে স্যার।
এবং এক্ষেত্রে কোনো প্রবলেম হলে ডু কাম উইথ মি অ্যান্ড টেক কোঅপারেশন ফ্রম মি, আই উইল সাপোর্ট ইউ।
ওকে স্যার, আর একটা ছোট প্রশ্ন, আমি যখন সাবমিট করব তার আগে যদি আমাকে প্ল্যাগারিজম চেক করতে হয়, তাহলে কি আমি লাইব্রেরিতে গিয়ে চেক করতে হবে বা অনলাইনে বসে?
আমি ওই যে তোমাকে বললাম, তুমি আমার কাছ থেকে অ্যাকাউন্ট চাইতে পারো, আমি তোমাকে আপলোড করার অ্যাকাউন্ট দিয়ে দেবো। তোমার রিপোর্টটা কোথায় ডাউনলোড করাবে, ঠিক আছে, তুমি রিপোর্টটা কোথায় ডাউনলোড করাবে, তার জন্য তুমি তোমার আরিসির গাইড বা হেডের কোনো অ্যাকাউন্ট ব্যবহার করতে পারো। প্রত্যেকের আছে, অমিত বাবুরও আছে, সুজিত বাবুর আছে, সাঁতরা বাবুর আছে, আর হচ্ছে রফিকুল্লারও আছে। অথবা ধরো পেলে না, অসুবিধা, প্যান্ডামিকে ফোন ধরছেন না বা কোনো অসুবিধা, তুমি লাইব্রেরি ওয়েবসাইটে চলে যাও, আমি তোমাকে দেখাচ্ছি। জিষ্ণু একটু স্ক্রিন শেয়ার করে তুমি ওখানে দেখাতে পারবে? হ্যাঁ, আমি স্ক্রিন শেয়ার করে জিষ্ণুকে বলছি, দেখো ও লাইব্রেরি দেখাচ্ছে, ওর মধ্যে অন্য কোনো কোয়েশ্চেন আসলে আমি নিয়ে নিচ্ছি। আমরা স্ক্রিন শেয়ার করে দেখাচ্ছি যে লাইব্রেরি টিমের, দেখো আমাদের ওর কোন অ্যানালিসিস আইডি দেওয়া আছে, তোমরা কেউ দেখোনি বলেই হয়তো জানো না, আমাদের ওয়েবসাইট এখন বাড়ি থেকে অ্যাক্সেস করা যায়, এবং আমাদের ওয়েবসাইটের মধ্যে দেখবে যে আমাদের নিজেদের টিমের মধ্যে ভারতবর্ষের বিভিন্ন লাইব্রেরিতে জানে আমাদের কিন্তু সেইটা আছে। জাস্ট জিষ্ণু ওটা খুলে দেখাচ্ছে, আমি বলছি মিন হোয়াইল এনি ইফ এনি কোয়েশ্চেন। আর কোনো কোয়েশ্চেন কেউ করতে চাও? কৌশিক কোনো চ্যাট বক্সে কিছু আছে? জিষ্ণুদা গিয়ে আওয়ার টিমে গেছে, আওয়ার টিমের আন্ডারে দেখো ওই যে নিমাই চন্দ্র লেখা আছে তার নিচেই দেখো যেটা নীলকারিতে ব্লক করেছে দেখো উড়কুন্ড অ্যানালাইসিস অ্যাড্রেস, তার নিচে সুজিত দা, সুজিত দা এখন সিকিম ইউনিভার্সিটি চলে গেছে, দেবব্রত হাজারি, তার নিচে দেখো কৌশিক দা, এরকম প্রত্যেকের নামের নিচে বেশিরভাগ ক্ষেত্রে দেখো অ্যানালাইসিস অ্যাড্রেস আছে। এবার মনে করো তুমি আরিসি পিএসভি লাইব্রেরি, পিএসভি লাইব্রেরিতে ক্লিক করো, সুজিকে পিএসভিএল অন্য ওইটা না ভি ভি তার পাশে, হ্যাঁ দেখো পিএসভি লাইব্রেরি ইনচার্জ হচ্ছে ম্যাডাম ডক্টর সাভাত নৌসিন, ওখানে সুকুমার দা আছে আর ওখানে নিতাই দা আছে, দেখো তিনজন অ্যানালাইসিস অ্যাড্রেস আছে। সো ইউ আর নট সাপোজ টু কাম টু সেন্ট্রাল লাইব্রেরি ফিজিক্যালি অ্যান্ড ভার্চুয়ালি টু, ইউ ক্যান টেক হেল্প ফ্রম ইউর লাইব্রেরি টু ইউর ডিপার্টমেন্ট টু অ্যান্ড অফকোর্স সেন্ট্রাল লাইব্রেরি টু, অ্যান্ড ডিউরিং দিস প্যান্ডেমিক উই আর নট ওয়েলকাম ইউ ইন ফিজিক্যালি অ্যাট দ্য লাইব্রেরি, আপলোড ফ্রম ইউর হাউস অর ইউ ক্যান সেন্ড ফাইল মেল টু আস, উই ক্যান আপলোড অ্যান্ড সেন্ড ইউ রেজাল্ট, বাট ইট উইল বি বেটার টু চেক ফ্রম ইউর সাইড অ্যান্ড কনসিভ রেজাল্ট টু ইউর গাইড অ্যান্ড হেডস অ্যাকাউন্ট সো দ্যাট ইট উইল বি ইজিয়ার টু গো থ্রু দ্যাট। ইন অ্যাডিশন টু দ্যাট ইউ সি দ্য বিউটি অফ দ্য বিশ্বজিৎ লাইব্রেরি, আই থিঙ্ক অনলি ওয়ান ইন ইন্ডিয়া, ওই যে পাশে যেটা চেক করো ব্লাড গ্রুপ লিস্ট, ব্লাড গ্রুপ লিস্ট তার নিচে উপরে ওইটা ওইটা হ্যাঁ, ইউ সি দিস ইজ দ্য মাস্টারি অফ দ্য বিশ্বজিৎ লাইব্রেরি, দ্য ডাইরেক্টর বিশ্বজিৎ লাইব্রেরি স্টাফ অ্যালং উইথ দ্য ব্লাড গ্রুপ রিপোর্ট, ইউ সি অ্যাট দি এন্ড কলাম বি প্লাস ও প্লাস ও নেগেটিভ অল দ্য স্টাফ মেম্বার্স হ্যাভিং দিস ব্লাড গ্রুপ রিপোর্ট, হু নোজ ইন এনি কেস হোয়েন এভার এনি স্টুডেন্টস অর এনি স্টাফ গট অ্যাডমিশন ইন সামওয়্যার এলস পার্টিকুলারলি বিশ্বভারতী হসপিটাল অর শ্রেয়ান হসপিটাল ওয়ান বটল অফ ব্লাড, সো হিয়ার ইজ এ কাইন্ড অফ সোর্স, আই ডোন্ট নো ইট মে ম্যাচ মে নট ম্যাচ হিজ হেলথ কন্ডিশন অর হেলথ কন্ডিশন মে বি ট্রাভেলসাম মে নট বি সামওয়্যার এলস, বাট দ্য অ্যাটিটিউড মেক্স এ ডিফারেন্স, সো দিস ইজ দ্য বিশ্বভারতী লাইব্রেরি, হোয়াই উই আর অলওয়েজ ওয়ান ইঞ্চ অ্যাহেড ইন ইন্ডিয়ান লাইব্রেরি সিস্টেম, it is a new thing, just one month ago we have introduced these things, so there are many things I fervently appeal to all of my academic galaxy and my scholars too, please come to the Vishwarathi library, browse Vishwarathi library WhatsApp group, Telegram group, and you will get lots of things in the Vishwarathi library website, and of course we have given one feedback link, may I request you all to submit the WhatsApp that link to feedback so that we will encourage and we will find out the corrective measure how to revitalize our library services to make you more and more useful for yourself. Okay, so these are the things. Kunal, don't worry. Your question was so nice. I am interested to show you. And you know, it's a kind of participatory game. Unless you communicate with us, how your problem will be solved. So don't think that you are alone. Even in this pandemic days, your department, your Vishwarathi as a whole and library in particular, always with you all, and we are trying to do something for the betterment of the library services during this pandemic days. In your house, you have library card, your ID password, your library card, your ID, and password is your BB123. You can browse and download the e-resources and catalog search, many things you can do, and this LS Discovery classes will be day after tomorrow. Do join and enjoy the accessibility and facility of Vishwarathi library, okay?
বাংলাতে লিখছি কোনো কিছু ব্যবহার করছি ইউনিকোডে লিখছি, তখন সেটার কিভাবে হয় আর উরকুন সফটওয়্যারটা কিভাবে প্লেজারিজম চেক করে, মানে কিভাবে এটা কাজ করে, এটা একটা প্রশ্ন। আর আমি বাংলাতে লিখছি, পরবর্তীকালে আমি কি ইংলিশে মানে থিসিসটা লিখতে পারি বা সাবমিশনের সময় ইংলিশে লিখে দিতে পারি, এই তিনটে প্রশ্ন আমার যদি একটু উত্তর দেন।
আচ্ছা, এখন থিসিসের বাংলা লেখা হবে না ইংরেজিতে লেখা হবে, এটা হচ্ছে যে কনসার্ন ডিপার্টমেন্ট বা গাইড তারাই ভালো বলতে পারবে। থিসিস আমি যতদূর জানি আমাদের ইউনিভার্সিটিতে বাইলিঙ্গুয়াল হয়, মানে বাংলাতেও থিসিস লেখা যায়, কিন্তু যদি এটা রিসার্চ বোর্ড আছে আমাদের ইউনিভার্সিটির, তারপর রিসার্চ রেগুলেটরি বোর্ড বা ডিপার্টমেন্টাল যারা গাইড আছেন তাদের কাছে জিজ্ঞাসা করবে যে আমি সঙ্গীত ভবনে আমার থিসিসটা বাংলাতে লিখব না ইংরেজিতে লিখব। যদি তোমার ইংলিশ লেখার ক্ষেত্রে এফিসিয়েন্সি বা কনফিডেন্স থাকে, আই ডু ওয়েলকাম টু রাইট ইন ইংলিশ, বিকজ কি হবে যে রেস্ট অফ দ্য কান্ট্রিতে যেখানে নন বেঙ্গলি জোন সেখানে তুমি অনেক বেশি সাইটেশন এবং তোমার থিসিসটা অনেক বেশি ব্যবহার হবে, এবং ইন গ্লোবাল সিনারিও ইংলিশে লিখলে কি হয় যে আমাদের ইয়েটা পাবে তুমি, মানে সাইটেশন বা তোমার থিসিসটা পপুলারিটি পাবে, দিস ইজ নাম্বার ওয়ান। এবারে তুমি কি করে চেক করবে সেটা আমি দেখালাম যে আমার পাওয়ার পয়েন্ট প্রেজেন্টেশন দিয়ে, যে তুমি ফাইলটা ইংরেজিতে লেখো কি বাংলায় লেখো দ্যাট ইজ ইমেটেরিয়াল, আমাদের কথা হচ্ছে তুমি বাংলাতে টাইপ করো বা ইংরেজিতে টাইপ করো দ্যাট মাস্ট বি কমপ্লায়েন্ট উইথ ইউনিকোড, এই ইউনিকোড শব্দটার মানে কি অনেকে বুঝতে পারে, ইউনিকোড শব্দটার মানে হচ্ছে যে বাংলাতে অনেক সফটওয়্যার আছে, যেমন অভ্র আছে, শ্রীলিপি আছে, সঞ্জয় আছে, তুলিকা আছে, এই যে চারটে সফটওয়্যার আরও আছে, আমি চারটে সফটওয়্যার কথা বললাম, কমার্শিয়াল প্রেসগুলো বেসিক্যালি বাংলা ওয়ার্ডটা ব্যবহার করে, কারণ বাংলা ওয়ার্ডটার মধ্যে একটু ফ্রেন্ডলিনেস ওরা পেয়ে যায়। আর আমাদের অভ্রতেও ফেসিলিটি আছে, আমাদের ইউনিকোড কমপ্লায়েন্ট, আর তার সাথে হচ্ছে যে আমাদের কিবোর্ডের সাথে বাংলা কম্পাটেবিলিটি করে রাইট করার ব্যবস্থা এখানে আছে। তাহলে যদি আমি বাংলা অভ্রটা ব্যবহার করি, বাংলা অভ্রটা এই যেটা ইন্টারন্যাশনালি অ্যাকসেপ্টেড সফটওয়্যার, এই ইউনিভার্সাল কোড মানে আমরা বলছি যে সফটওয়্যারটা সারা পৃথিবীতে রেকগনাইজ, সেইটাকে আমরা বলছি ইউনিকোড কমপ্লায়েন্ট সফটওয়্যার, মানে ইউনিভার্সালি কোডটা অ্যাক্সেসেবল এবং অ্যাপ্রোচেবল এবং অ্যাকসেপ্টেড সেইটাকে বলছি। আর যে সফটওয়্যারটা যেমন বাংলা ওয়ার্ড, বাংলা ওয়ার্ড হয়তো পশ্চিমবাংলায় চলে, কলকাতায় চলে, পাবলিকেশন ইন্ডাস্ট্রিতে, তার বাইরে আর কেউ জানে না। সো দ্যাট সফটওয়্যার মে নট বি অ্যাপ্রোচেবল টু উডকুন্ড অ্যান্ড সুইডেন টু, সেক্ষেত্রে আমরা বলি বাংলা ওয়ার্ড, শ্রীলিপি, সঞ্জয়, টেকলিপ এগুলো ব্যবহার না করাটাই ভালো। উডকুন্ডে আমরা যদি ইয়ে লিখি, ওই অভ্রতে লিখি, কোনো অসুবিধা নেই, অভ্র সফটওয়্যার কিন্তু ইউনিকোড কমপ্লায়েন্ট, এবং গো অ্যাহেড উইথ অভ্র, এবং অভ্র ইউনিকোড ব্যবহার করে আমরা যদি নির্মলা ইউ, লিখন, যে কোনো টাইপ অফ ফন্টটা আমাদের কোনো ইয়ে নেই, করে তুমি যদি আপলোড থিসিসটা লেখো, এবং থিসিসটা লেখার পরে তুমি সেটাকে ডক ফাইলে সেভ করতে পারো, তুমি সেটা পিডিএফ ফাইলে সেভ করতে পারো, 21টা ফাইল ফরম্যাট আমার উডকুন্ড বা অরিজিনাল অ্যাকসেপ্ট করে। করার পরে তোমরা কি করবে, করার পরে তোমরা ওই ফাইলটা কি করে আপলোড করতে, আমি পাওয়ার পয়েন্ট প্রেজেন্টেশনে দেখালাম, তো তুমি নিজে আপলোড করতে পারো, অথবা তুমি তোমার গাইডের মাধ্যমে আপলোড করতে পারো, অথবা তুমি লাইব্রেরিতে চাইলে আমরা করেই ধরো অপশনালি, তো সেটা আপলোড করে রিপোর্টটা তুমি পেয়ে যাচ্ছ। এইবারে উডকুন্ড এর ভিতরে কি করে কাজ করে যে প্রশ্ন তুমি করেছো, যদিও টেকনিক্যাল কোয়েশ্চেন, খুব বেশি উত্তর এই সার্কিটে চা দিস, তুই তো যদি যদি তুমি কি করে ব্যাপারটা বুঝতে পারবে, আমি তোমাকে বলছি যে ধরো উডকুন্ড কি কাজ করে। এখন ওই যে আমি একটা কথা প্রেজেন্টেশনের সময় বলেছিলাম, সময় যেন আমি এড়িয়ে গেছিলাম, তুমি আমাকে ইনসিস্ট করলে যে উত্তরটা দিয়ে ওই বিষয়টাকে উত্থাপন করার, ধরো তুমি উডকুন্ড কি করে, উডকুন্ডে যে বাস্কেট বা টার্নিটাইনের একটা বাস্কেট আছে, কালেকশন বাস্কেট বা আইথেন্টিকেটর কালেকশন বাস্কেট আছে, এরা কি করে সমস্ত পৃথিবী থেকে ফ্রি অ্যান্ড ওপেন অ্যাক্সেস সফটওয়্যার এবং কিছু রিনাউন্ড পাবলিশারের কাছ থেকে তাদের একটা টাই আপ থাকে, সেই টাই আপ থেকে তারা তাদের ফুল টেক্সট ওখানে জমা রেখে দিয়েছে। এবার আমি যখন কোনো একটা ফাইল ওখানে আপলোড করছি, ওরা আমার ফাইলটাকে নিয়ে গিয়ে ওখানে প্রত্যেকটা ফাইলে সে স্নোবল গেম খেলায়, অর্থাৎ কোনো একটা পাবলিকেশন ইন্ডাস্ট্রি নিল, নিয়ে তার সাথে ম্যাচ করলো কি করলো না, যদি না করলো ওটা ফেলে দিল, আবার একটা নিল, আবার একটা নিল, এইভাবে তারা ওটাকে ম্যাচিং করায়, করিয়ে সিমিলারিটি পেলে আমাকে সিমিলারিটি পার্সেন্টেজটা দিচ্ছে, আর যদি না পায় আমাকে জিরো বলছে। এইবারে আমার প্রশ্ন হচ্ছে যে তোমাকে জিরো বললো তার মানে তুমি যে খুব আনন্দ করতে পারবে তা কিন্তু নয়। এখন মনে করো যে রবি ঠাকুরের অচলায়তন, রক্তকরবী, গল্পগুচ্ছ, এই যে সময়কার বা অনেক পুরনো শেক্সপিয়ারের যে বইগুলো আছে সেগুলো হয়তো এখন অনলাইন বা ডিজিটাইজ ভার্সনে অ্যাভেলেবল নয়, কিন্তু তুমি বিইং এ স্কলার অফ সঙ্গীত ভবন বা বাংলা ডিপার্টমেন্ট বিশ্বভারতীর বা যে কোনো ডিপার্টমেন্টে তুমি কনসিয়াসলি আমার বিশ্বভারতীর কোনো লাইব্রেরি থেকে বা রবীন্দ্রভবনের কোনো লাইব্রেরির বই নিয়ে তুমি সেখানে ব্যবহার করলে, উডকুন্ড তোমাকে ধরতে পারলো না, বললো তোমার ক্লিন চিট 0%, এইবার যখন ওই রিপোর্টটা বা ওই থিসিসটা কখনো অধ্যাপক অমলবাবু দেখলেন বা অধ্যাপক মানবেন্দ্রবাবু দেখলেন বা বাংলার যারা এমিনেন্ট স্কলার আছেন তারা চোখে পড়লো, তখন তারা যদি বলে শুভদীপ বা জিষ্ণুদা তোমরা তো এই জিনিসটা এখান থেকে লিখেছো কিন্তু এটা কেন সাইট করো নি ভাই, তাহলে কিন্তু তুমি আবার সেই ফ্যাসাদে পড়বে, ওই কলে পড়ে যাবে, উডকুন্ডের মামলা, তোমার রিপোর্ট কিন্তু সেভ করবে না। সেই জন্য আমি তোমাদেরকে বলেছি স্কলারদেরকে যে বেসিক্যালি আমাকে গ্রামারটা দেখতে হবে, যে আমি কোনো জায়গা থেকে একটু লেখা নিতেই পারি, এবং সোশ্যাল সায়েন্সের ক্ষেত্রে, ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ লিটারেচারের ক্ষেত্রে, হিউম্যানিটিজের ক্ষেত্রে বা আমাদের যে সফট সায়েন্সের ক্ষেত্রে আমরা নেবই, হার্ড সায়েন্সের ক্ষেত্রে আমরা নেবই, প্রিভিয়াস স্টাডি নিতে কোনো আপত্তি নেই, কেউ মানা করেনি, একটাই আপত্তি ওই যেখান থেকে আমি লেখা নিচ্ছি তাকে প্রপার সাইট অ্যান্ড রেফার আমি করেছি কি করিনি, যদি করি তাহলে সেটা দেখলেই তো আমি দেখালাম যে যদি আমরা কোট করে থাকি তাহলে সেটা কিন্তু এক্সেম্পটেড। সো দিস ইজ অল অ্যাবাউট অন ইওর আনসার শুভদীপ, আই থিঙ্ক আমরা অনেকটা সময় নিয়েছি, অনেক কোয়েশ্চেনও নিয়েছি, এরপরে হয়তো তোমাদের মনে হবে যে আরও অনেক কোয়েশ্চেন আছে, 170 জন মতন টোটাল জয়েন করেছিল, এখন প্রায় 87 জন হয়ে গেছে, মানে 50% ডিপ করে গেছে, তো আমার মনে হচ্ছে যে হ্যাঁ
একটা কোশ্চেন আছে দাদা, সেটা হচ্ছে কোন ফরম্যাটে আপলোড করব, ডক ফরম্যাটে আপলোড
করব, এনিওয়ান অ্যাজ ইউ থিং, নো ইস্যু
স্যার। একটা কোশ্চেন ছিল স্যার, যদি একটু টাইম এ হয়ে যায় স্যার,
কি প্রশ্ন
হ্যাঁ স্যার বলছিলাম আমি কুতুবুদ্দিন ঢালি বিদ্যুৎ বিদ্যাভবন থেকে বলছি, জিওগ্রাফি ডিপার্টমেন্ট থেকে। স্যার বলছি এখানে সবগুলো বুঝলাম অল্প অল্প করে, কিন্তু ব্যাপারটা হচ্ছে স্যার কোনো চ্যাপ্টারের মধ্যে বা কোনো যদি পেপারের মধ্যে কোনো ইমেজ থাকে বা ফিগার থাকে সেগুলো কি উরকুন অ্যাকসেপ্ট করতে পারে, বা সেগুলোর ক্ষেত্রে আমরা কি করতে পারি যদি প্রিভিয়াসলি কোনো ইমেজ কোনো পেপারে আমরা অলরেডি।
হ্যাঁ বলি, এখানে এটা জিওগ্রাফি ডিপার্টমেন্টের অতীতে এই প্রশ্ন এসছে আমার কাছে। আমি বলছি যে এবং আমাদের মিডিয়া, মিডিয়া বলতে আমাদের কমিউনিকেশন সাবজেক্ট যেটা জার্নালিজম মাস কম, এদের ক্ষেত্রেও আছে। আর দেখো বা ইকোনমিক্সেও আসতে পারে, যে কোনো সায়েন্সেও আসতে পারে, আমাদের জুলজি বটানি এদের ক্ষেত্রেও আসতে পারে। সেখানে আমাদের উত্তরটা হচ্ছে যে আমার কাছে কিন্তু ছবি নিয়ে আমি গবেষণা করছি না, অর্থাৎ কলাভবনের বি ফাইন এম ফাইন পড়ে যারা পিএইচডি করছে বা আমাদের শিল্প সদনে পড়ে যারা পিএইচডি করছে, আর আমরা যারা এই দুটো ভবন বাদ দিয়ে পিএইচডি করছি, বা যদি ছবিটাই আমার রিসার্চ হয় সেখানে আমি রামকিঙ্কর বিজয় নন্দলাল বোসের যদি কোনো একটা ছবি নিয়ে তার নিচে যদি আমি সাইটেশন না দিই তাহলে সেটা কিন্তু অপরাধ। কিন্তু মনে করো আমি ভারতবর্ষের একটা ম্যাপ, আমি বীরভূমের একটা ম্যাপ বা সিউড়ির কোনো একটা গ্রামের ম্যাপ, জিওগ্রাফিক্যাল বা ট্রপিক্যাল জোনের একটা ম্যাপ আমি নিয়েছি, সেই ম্যাপটা যেখান থেকে তুমি পাচ্ছ ডিস্ট্রিক্টের ওয়েবসাইট থেকে পেতে পারি, আমাদের কোনো নেটমোর ওয়েবসাইট থেকে আমি পেতে পারি, তাহলে নিচে তোমরা দয়া করে লিখে দেবে সোর্সটা কী ওই ম্যাপের বা সোর্সটা কী ওই পিকচারের, তাহলে কোনো অসুবিধা নেই। আর ফিল্ড সার্ভে করতে গিয়ে যেমন সঙ্গীত ভবনের, যেমন ফোক কালচারের ক্ষেত্রে তোমাদের জিওগ্রাফির ক্ষেত্রে অনেক সময় দরকার হয় যে কোনো সময় একটা ড্রেসিং করছে বা কেউ গান গাইছে বা কেউ ভাদু গান করছে, আমি তার একটা ছবি তুললাম, সেখানে আমি তাদের অনুমতি নিয়ে ছবি তুলি এবং ওটা লিখে দেবো যে তার পিকচার কাটছে ফ্রম যার কাছ থেকে ছবিটা নিয়েছে তার নামটা দেবো, অ্যান্ড টেকিং অ্যাট্রিবিউশন ফ্রম দি প্রপার অথরিটি, কম্পিটেন্ট অথরিটি বা সেক্রেটারি অফ দি অ্যাসোসিয়েশন, সেক্রেটারি অফ দি ক্লাব বা প্রোগ্রাম প্রডিউসার, যে কোনো একটা ওখানে তুমি যদি লিখে দাও তাহলে কিন্তু, কারণ আমরা এটা মনে রাখবে জিওগ্রাফির ক্ষেত্রে বেশিরভাগ ক্ষেত্রে বা আমরা যে কোনো সাবজেক্টের ক্ষেত্রে ছবিটা আমাদের গবেষণার বিষয় না, এই বিষয়টা কনসেপ্টলি ডিফারেন্ট ফ্রম বি ফাইন এম ফাইন বা আমাদের কলাভবনের স্টুডেন্টদের ক্ষেত্রে বা আমাদের শিল্পজনের স্টুডেন্টদের থেকে আমাদের ক্ষেত্রে আলাদা। আমরা তো পিকচারটা আমাদের কন্টেন্ট না, পিকচারটা তো আমাদের সাবসিডিয়ারি কন্টেন্ট বা সাপোর্টিং টেক্সট টু এলাবোরেট দ্য ফ্যাক্ট, ঠিক আছে? সুতরাং ওইটা নিয়ে আমাদের অত চিন্তা করার কিছু, কিন্তু ছবিটা তুমি যেখান থেকে নিচ্ছ ভাই, ছবির নিচে তুমি দেখবে অ্যাটলাস খুলবে, সেখানে নিচে সোর্স দেওয়া থাকে, সেই সোর্স যেন তোমরা দেবে আর কি, ঠিক আছে?
থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার, থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ।
আই থিঙ্ক মাচ হ্যাভ বিন ডিসকাসড। কৌশিক
দুটো আমার একটা কৌশিক ছিল,
সুমন কর্মকার কি কোশ্চেন?
সুমন কর্মকার স্যার, বোটানি ডিপার্টমেন্ট। স্যার বলছি যে উরকুন্দে কি আমরা, আমি এথনোবোটানিতে রিসার্চ করি, তো যে টেবিল দেওয়া হয় তো পেপারও পাবলিশ করি, বা সেই টেবিল গুলো কি উরকুন্দে প্লাজিয়ারিজম চেক হয়? টেবিলে অনেক আমাদের গাছের গাছের ক্ষেত্রে আমরা যে টেবিল গুলো দিই। আরেকটা স্যার কোশ্চেন ছিল স্যার, বিশ্বভারতী থিসিস সাবমিটের সময় যে পেপার গুলো সাবমিট করতে হয় সেগুলো কি স্যার ইউজিসি এর মানে কেয়ার লিস্টেড জার্নালি পাবলিশ হতে হবে, না যদি ইউজিসি কেয়ার লিস্টেড না হয় সেটা যদি বলেন একটু স্যার?
আমি বলছি ওই ওই আগের যে কুনালের প্রশ্নের উত্তর আবারও বলবো, তুমি যদি মনে করো বোটানি সরি হ্যাঁ তোমার এথনোবোটানির কোনো একটা রিনাউন্ড জার্নাল আছে যে জার্নালটা ইউজিসি কেয়ার লিস্টে নেই, ঠিক আছে, তুমি তোমার হেডকে বা তুমি তোমার গাইডকে বললে ওই কেয়ার লিস্টে কন্ট্যাক্ট মেল আছে, একটা মেল ড্রপ করলে জার্নালটা ডিটেলস দিলে ইট উইল টেক ওয়ান মান্থ অর সামথিং, একটা ইমিডিয়েট মিটিং ওরা ওটা আপলোড করে দেবে, ওটা একটা এনলিস্টেড করে দেবে। হোয়াট ইজ দ্য প্রবলেম দেয়ার? দ্যাট ইজ দ্য ফার্স্ট আনসার। সেকেন্ড আনসার হচ্ছে আমি তোমাকে বলবো অ্যাজ এ দাদা, নট অ্যাজ এ একাডেমিশিয়ান, বেটার নট টু পাবলিশ এলসওয়্যার আদার দ্যান কেয়ার লিস্টেড। তাহলে কি হয় পরে তোমাকে ওটা জাস্টিফাই করতে হবে, যদি তোমার থিসিসের এক্সপার্ট বা তোমার কখনো সিলেকশন কমিটির এক্সপার্ট ওটা অপছন্দ করে, ব্যক্তিগত পছন্দ অপছন্দের জায়গায় থাকতে পারে, তাহলে তুমি বিইং এ ক্যান্ডিডেট তোমার ডিফেন্স উনি অ্যাকসেপ্ট করতে পারেন না করতে পারেন, সেক্ষেত্রে তোমার রিক্রুটমেন্ট বা তোমার সিলেকশন বা তোমার অ্যাওয়ার্ডটা হয়তো বা ডেফার্ড হলেও হতে পারে, তো ওয়াই ক্যান আই টেক দ্যাট রিস্ক? সেই জন্য আমি বলবো বিফোর দ্যাট ওই জার্নালটাকে তুমি এনলিস্ট করো। আমি তো বললাম যে আমাদের কোয়াই পত্রিকা, আমি খারাপ ভালো মন্দ বলছি না, কোয়াই পত্রিকা ইউজিসি এনলিস্টেড, তাহলে কেন তোমার এথনোবোটানির একটা ভালো জার্নাল আমরা ইউজিসি কেয়ার লিস্টে দিতে পারছি না? ইউজিসি ওখানে ইনভাইট করেছিল যে আপনারা আপনাদের জার্নাল কোনগুলো দিতে হবে দিন, আমরা কেয়ার কমিটিকে দিয়ে, আমি যেটা বললাম কনসোর্টিয়াম ফর একাডেমিক রিসার্চ এথিক্স, ওই কমিটির কাছে প্লেস করবে, একটা কমিটি আছে, সেই কমিটিটা অ্যাকসেপ্ট করে দিচ্ছে 90% ক্ষেত্রে অ্যাকসেপ্ট হয়ে যাচ্ছে, তোমরা দাও, যদি দিলে না হয় বা যদি আমার দিক থেকে কোনো পারফরমেন্স লাগে আমি দেবো, কিন্তু আমি রেকমেন্ড করবো যে কেয়ার লিস্টের অন্তর্ভুক্ত জার্নালেই যেন রিসার্চ রিলেটেড কোয়ালিফিকেশনসটা করা হয়, করলে সেটা তুমি সব দিক থেকে সেফ গাইডেড থাকবে আর কি, সেলফ প্র্যাকটিস, ঠিক আছে?
থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার।
দাদা কিছু পার্সোনাল কোশ্চেন ছিল তো সেটার জন্য আপনার সাথে কিভাবে কন্ট্যাক্ট করবো দাদা?
ওই যে আবার একই প্রশ্ন ঘুরে যাচ্ছে, আমার মেল আইডি আছে,
আমার
একটা এমার্জেন্সি ফোন এসে, কৌশিক তুমি আমার মনে হয় সেশনটা ওয়াইন্ড আপ করো।
Okay, actually, thank you, Nimaida, for your such kind of tremendous session. So already we are time is almost over. Time is near about 1 p.m. onwards. So actually, in our library website, all library officers and the library professionals have their email IDs and along with the mail ID. Mail ID along with the WhatsApp number also. So if any query related to any particular topic, you may send your query. So thank you. Hopefully all you all submit your Google feedback form. And tomorrow there is another session on registration in Vidyan database. So thank you all.